Well, I've been involved my entire life, and certainly my political career, with environmental issues, particularly climate change and wildlife protection. I've done a lot in the city of Los Angeles, which most people don't realize has a lot of wildlife, especially in the hills. So we're doing wildlife corridors and other things to protect them. I've also been very involved in elephant issues, and most recently trying to get Billy out of the zoo into a sanctuary. I also authored the legislation that prevented Ringling Brothers from bringing their elephants and their circus to Los Angeles, and eventually led to Ringling Brothers eliminating their elephants from their circus.
Wow, that's amazing. I am a
animal
lover, animal rights activist.
We're so glad that you're here today.
Oh, thank you.
I think a lot of people don't realize that animals and the environment are more connected than they think, because the animals are
Well, certainly the things we do to market animals, beef production, chicken production, all those activities create a lot of global warming, a lot of methane gas, we need to do something to dramatically reduce all sources of climate changing gases, and that certainly would be one of them. So if people ate more vegetarians, it would reduce a dramatic amount of our greenhouse gas.
How are you?
Well, recycling is significant. A lot of people don't realize how many things are recycled. And so we've been creating a much grander recycling program in the city of Los Angeles, and that out. Certainly, you can eliminate gas guzzling vehicles. I recently got a Chevy Volt, which, if you've driven the Chevy Volt, it's actually a much better designed car. It has about a 250-mile tank, quote unquote, which is a pretty good distance. And it has a lot of zip to it, too. So it's a great car and not that expensive. So people can save a lot of gasoline that way and help clean up the air that way.
Right.
So
I've done a lot of work with the Sierra Club over the years. There's one I'm working with them with the program they had today called Pando Populous. And that group did what they call their first junk battle. They had a number of colleges, and each one had to figure out how to use junk for marketable products. And it was actually a fascinating opportunity, but hopefully that'll reduce the amount of waste by finding uses for things that normally would just be trash.